Yes, coming back to the mathematical analysis methods, first one is center line average method, second one is 10 point height average value, which is represented as RZ, 10 point height average value. Then root mean square value, RMS, which is also represented as R cube. Root mean square value, R cube. Root mean square value, R cube. In the bracket you mentioned R cube. So now, first of all, if you concentrate on the first method, that is first mathematical analysis method, that is center line average value method. So here, what it is saying? So here, roughness average RA is the arithmetic average of the absolute values of the roughness profiles or nodes. So here, for suppose if you consider a center line over here, okay, from the data. So from that center line, how much deviation is happened for the valley and peak? Suppose within these irregularities of a surface, if you consider highest point is a peak and lowest point is a deep or valley. So peak is having height and this valley is having deep. Okay. So now what is happening? We are going to find out the average value of these areas. So here A1 is nothing but whatever the area is there, this area we are finding. Similarly, A2 area, A3 area, A4, A5 and A6. And by getting these values, what we are saying, the arithmetic average of the absolute values we are going to consider. So nothing but here, if you simplify it, RA, that is the center line average value, is equivalent to A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 plus A5 plus A6 plus so on AN by L. So L is the sampling length over here. Okay. So the sampling, within the sampling length, whatever the from the center line, how much deviation is occurred, so that areas we are going to find out. So by means of those areas, if you summarize this, or if you get the average of those arithmetic mean values, then and it is divided with the sampling length, then that value is going to give us the roughness value in center line average value method. Okay, so as here, what we are saying, whatever the roughness values we are getting, we are going to make it in the mathematical format. So further say, we are keeping the roughness values or irregular values whichever are there on the surface in between the center line or mean line, and above and below how much areas that irregularities are covered, that area we are going to find out. By that you will get A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 values, and if you make an average of it and divide it with the sampling length, you are going to get the roughness value. Okay. So under center line average value method, please make a representation of this figure and that formula, and also the write-up part which is shown over here. So here L is the sampling length. That means within this sampling length, whatever the values we are going to get, irregularities are getting, so those values are going to be considered. Well, because RA, roughness value, which is going to exist in small sampling lengths. here L is the sampling length. Within that, whatever the irregularities are there, so those areas we are going to find out. So by that we will get the roughness values. So this is a one of the mathematical analysis method by which we can find out the roughness value of a given surface. Yes, all of you please draw this figure and formula and also the information within the boxes. So keep one point within your mind that these are the methods whenever we are interested to find out the roughness values by mathematical approach. If you are going at that moment, you will get the roughness values like this. Instead of this, if you go with the measurement devices, then at that moment that will be different. Okay, so here our discussion point is, first we need to concentrate on the surface, what are the symbolic representation of the surface, and after that, what are the measuring methods, techniques we are having. Under that, we are having mathematical as well as instrumental. Under mathematical analysis manner, we are looking these formulas or these particular mathematical methods, that is central line average method, root mean square value method, and 10-point height method. RA, RQ and RZ, RA, RZ and RQ. Okay, so under mathematical analysis manner, we are observing this method, the center line method. So by this formula, we are going to get the roughness values. So this is the one way of finding the roughness values. So we can consider it as a measurement of roughness is going to be done by means of a central line average method whenever we approach the mathematical.
Sir, what sir, formula means A1 plus A2 plus so on AN by L, sir, formula? This formula you told, this one only, sir?
Yes.
RA is equal to A1 plus A2 plus so on AN by L.
Yes. Yes. Yes, is it over? Yashwant, is it over?
Yes, sir.
Now, let us move to the second method, that is 10-point height average value. So here the orange colored one, if you consider it is a surface where the irregularities are existing. So from a datum line, we are going to find out the heights of the peaks and valleys. So peak is from the center line or mean line, which is above, it is existing, that is a peak. And below the mean line, if it is existing, it is a valley. So that heights we are going to say it as P1, P2, P3, P4, P5. Similarly, valleys are V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. Okay. So here, 5 peak points, 5 valley values. So total 10 point height average value.
Sir, P means pressure, sir.
P means peak, P-E-A-K, peak.
Okay.
V means valley, V-A-L-L-Y, valley. So here, mean line, if you consider it is x-axis, right? And towards vertical side, it is a y-axis. So y coordinate or y ordinate, peak 1, peak 2, peak 3. Okay, y is nothing but towards the y-axis side. Yp2, yv1, yv3, yp1, yv2, like that. So here y representing towards the x-axis and y-axis. Y means y-axis. X is a mean line. So 5 peak values we are considering and 5 valley values we are considering, right? And below you can see the representation of that figured values in terms of RZ. RZ is equivalent to YP1 plus YP2 plus
YP3. Sir, what is this Y, sir? Y,
that means y 5 means, peak values we are considering minus 5 valley value. Values, average of value.
Sir, I'm asking. Sir, I'm asking YB this
one.
Y, sir.
Y direction, valley one. V means valley. V1, YV2, YV3, YV4, YV5. Okay. So after summation of peak values and valley values, we need to make a difference of it, and we need to get the average of it. So you need to show the second method name, that is 10 point height average value. In the bracket you mention RZ, and below whatever the figure is shown for us, please draw it. Okay. So the thick line is a datum line, and the light line, whichever is shown, which is parallel to the datum line, that is a mean line. From the mean line, the curve or the irregularities are distributed up and down. Okay, so the orange colored curve is a irregularities on the surface. So that surface is peaks and valley distances we are finding from the datum line. Okay, so as here the distances are existing towards the y direction, so we are calling it as yp2, yp1, yp3, yp4, like that. Even values are also towards y direction. So yv1, yv2, yv3, yv4, like that. Why? Because if you want to represent the irregularities, it is appropriate, or we need to show those ordinates within the x, y ordinates. So with that intention, we are showing the peaks and valleys with
Sir. Hello, sir.
YP2 is nothing but y direction.
Sir, we can peak, see that.
Peak 1, peak 3.
Sir, we can see that here YP2, YP1 mixed.
So this is a part of measurement of surface finish in mathematical approach. Mm-hmm. So whenever we are approaching mathematical analysis methods, this is the way which we need to find out the roughness values. So there is one more method is also existing for us, that is by means of instrumental method. That means by using one device, we are going to find out it. So after completion of these three kinds of mathematical analysis methods, we are going to see in the next class that how a surface finish is going to be measured with instruments. Yes, Ishwant, over.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, we can see that here YP2, like that mixed is there.
So here YP2 is nothing but peak 2, second peak.
I understood, sir. In the diagram, there is a, in this wave, any difference? This is the Y1, this is Y2. How we measure actually?
Here, which peak is highest one, that you need to tell as first one. Next immediate, next one is 2. Next one is 3, like that.
Okay, highest. Okay.
Is it over? Ashwant, is it over?
Yes, sir, over, sir.
So the last method in the mathematical analysis approach, root mean square value, RMS value, which is also denoted by RQ. So every time these irregularities are distributed in between the mean line and within a sampling length. So L is the sampling length, and mean line you can see over here. From that mean line, whatever the distribution is happened, you can see up and down like this.
Sir, I want to tell one thing, sir.
So this is the third method, root mean square, RMS value. In the bracket you mentioned RQ. So the first one is RA, second one is RZ, now third one is RQ. That means whenever irregularities are existing, you can approach any one method.
Sir, actually my attendance got less, sir.
Yes.
In metrology.
What happened?
Sir, attendance, sir.
Attendance, okay.
I got less, sir. 4 minus. 4 class minus I got, sir. In attendance, sir.
Okay.
Next month, you can make that attendance, sir.
Which one? What you are telling?
Actually, sir, this metrology, engineering metrology class attendance, sir, I didn't wrong you have came, sir. 4 minus classes, 4 class absent it is shown for me, sir. actually.
Sir, are you understanding, sir?
I'll complete the drawing and take the formula to get the value. RQ is equivalent to root of H1 square plus H2 square plus so on HN square by N.
అంటే సార్ ఈ మంత్ అటెండెన్స్ ఇచ్చారు సార్ మాకు లిస్ట్ ఆ లిస్ట్ లో ఏమైందంటే నా అటెండెన్స్ నాలుగు పీరియడ్ లో మైనస్ పడింది సార్
మైనస్ పడిందా
ఆ సార్ కరెక్ట్ గా అటెండెన్స్ రాలేదు ఆ నాలుగు పీరియడ్ లో నేను రాలేదని మైనస్ పడింది సార్
ఏ సబ్జెక్ట్
32 క్లాసులు ఈ మీ సబ్జెక్ట్ లోనే సార్
ఓకే
అంటే 32 క్లాసులకి 28 అలా పడినట్టు ఉంది సార్ 28 32 క్లాస్ కి కండక్ట్ చేశారు మీరు అంటే 28 నాకు అటెండెన్స్ వచ్చింది సార్ నేను వచ్చానని 28 క్లాస్ వచ్చానని వచ్చింది
నెక్స్ట్ టైం నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్ కి ఒక 4 యాడ్ చేద్దాం
ఓకే
yes is it over
yes sir for me over
like this here these are the three different kinds of mathematical methods by which we can measure the surface roughness okay and ultimately it will lead to the surface finish in the next class we are going to see the instrumental methods by which we can find out the surface roughness values okay so as time is exceeded now so I want to conclude the class here itself please all of you move to the next class I am ending the meeting here itself